I agree with Rabbi Tobias Singer and the majority of the Jewish community when it comes to what they teach on the five events that will occur when the Jewish Messiah comes. About a year ago, Rabbi Tobias Singer did a video on the five events that would occur when the Jewish Messiah would come. And I agree with those. The earth filled with the knowledge of the Lord, rebuking the nations, destruction of the enemies, war. The Jews will be unified, the final temple with worldwide peace, and the resurrection of the dead. I find no problem with none of these prophecies. I agree that they're biblical, they're sound, and this is what's going to happen. But here is the clincher. All these prophecies will happen after what the prophecies in the Bible show us, that the Jews would reject their own Messiah. Isaiah 28:16 has a beautiful prophecy there. It says, "Therefore, thus says the Lord, behold, I lay in Zion for a foundation, a stone, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. He that believeth shall not make haste." This is what Isaiah told us about the stone or the rock. And in Psalm 118, verse 22 and 23, "The stone which the builders refused is become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes." So the Bible teaches us in the Old Testament, Isaiah tells us that God is doing a work. He did a work that was marvelous. He would lay a foundation stone in Zion. But it says that the builders would reject it. This is what the Bible teaches that was going to happen before all the other wonderful prophecies were to take place. Jesus quoted this passage, the stone that the builders rejected, in several places. He quotes it in Matthew 21, in Mark 12, and he quotes it in Luke 20. This is so important that Jesus repeated it several times. And the apostles, including the apostle Peter, when they were taken before the synagogue, before the Jews, Peter said unto them that Jesus was the stone that you, the builders, rejected. So Peter applied that verse unto the Jewish people. This is incredible. Then later on, Paul writes about this in Romans 11. And he says that the blindness in part has happened to Israel until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. In other words, this prophecy is very clear, and it is still happening today. The Jewish people reject the stone. They reject Jesus Christ because they're blind in part until all the Gentiles that God is going to save come into the kingdom.